It took till 1977 for the Wildcats and Scots to get back together, and since then, my oh my, what kind of ball games we've played. In 77, a quarterfinal ball game, Highland Park jumped out to a 28-0 lead against the Plano Wildcats. The Wildcats won that game 29-28 on a two-point conversion, the last play of the ball game. And Brad, since then, the rivalry has really fueled a very hot fire.
That was a thriller. Of course, the cast of characters included a sophomore quarterback for Highland Park at the time, Lance McElhaney, his brother Lot McElhaney. For Plano, they were engineered by a fine quarterback by the name of Steve Ulmer. It was December 3rd, 1977. As you mentioned, Plano was down 28-0 midway through the third period. Magic was evident throughout the rest of the ball game as Plano was able to come back with a huge 29-28 win at the quarterfinal level. Of course, the Wildcats went on and won the state championship that year.
They sure did, Brad. And then in 78 and 79, the Wildcats and Scots were in the same district. They split those ball games. Highland Park won the first one 16-9 against the Wildcats. The second ball game, the Highland Park Scots came back. Oh, I'm sorry, the second ball game, Plano beat Highland Park 21-17 at Clark Stadium. Again, a last-second play for the Wildcats did it. And the final last time the Wildcats and Scots got together was in 1980.
Kevin, we were talking about the rivalry of these two ball clubs, relatively young, but tremendously intense. 77, a quarterfinal matchup, Plano won at 29-28. In 1978 and 79, the two ball clubs were in the same district, 13-4A. Plano won the district title both of those years. In 1980, they met again here at Texas Stadium in a quarterfinal matchup. The final there, Highland Park 23, Plano 21. It was the Scots who came back late to win that one. First, both ball clubs are on the field. Kevin Maloney, conditions prior to tonight's ball game.
A beautiful night for high school football, Brad. Temperature 45 degrees. Very little wind in here at Texas Stadium. Both ball clubs are very strong defensively. The Highland Park Scots will be receiving the opening kickoff, and the Plano Wildcats will be kicking off and defending the south goal. The Wildcats will be going from our right to our left with the Highland Park Scots defending the north goal. Brad, Wally McNeely is going to come out and tee this ball up. We're just moments away from the opening kickoff of what looks like is going to be a tremendous ball game between two very fine traditions. Offensively, the Wildcats have been scoring 25 points a ball game, and the Highland Park Scots have been averaging 24. So statistically, this is going to be a close ball game.
Wally McNeely has it teed up at the 40. We'll kick it off from right to left. He'll boot it away to a duo deployed by the Highland Park Scots. Inside the 5-yard line stands Steve Davis, and on the far side, Brandon Williams. There's the word, here's the approach. The kickoff of the goal, McNeely is high, and it comes down to Williams at the 3-yard line, middle of the field, 10 to the 15, up ended at the 16-yard line. Oh my, flying around, Mark Bowman filling his lane so very nicely on the kickoff team for the Wildcats. Also with late help on the play, Jeff Orosandich. First and 10, the Highland Park Scots with scrimmage from their own 17-yard line.
The Wildcats special teams are fired up tonight, as both sidelines are. It'll be first and 10 for the Highland Park Scots at their own 17-yard line, and we'll see what the Wildcat defense can do to start this ball game.
Field here, Stallingworth, the quarterback, takes to the first man through, rides it off a left tackle for not much. Pickup of a yard, maybe a yard and a half.
Okay, Brad, first let's quickly go over that play. It looks like it was a broken play for the Highland Park Scots. Brad, we're back to another play.
Here's the second down and 8 call from the Highland Park 19-yard line. Ball spotted at the left hash. Stallingworth, the left-hander, drops the throw. Has Clements at the 36-yard line. Dropped immediately by Kyle Moody. Substantial gain on the play. Initial first down recorded by the Highland Park Scots at the Scotty 36-yard line. Nice pass completion from Stallingworth to his favorite wide receiver, Wayne Clements. 17 yards on the hookup from Stallingworth to Clements. Spot the football at the right hash, first and 10 for the Highland Park Club. Spinning out from center, Stallingworth. Give it away to the first man through. Running back James Knoll finds an alley out to the 45-yard line. Knocked down by middle linebacker Johnny Harvey. Now before a pickup of 7, maybe 8 yards on the play for Highland Park.
A tremendous hole opened by Trey Smith, an offensive guard for the Highland Park Scots, and David Turner, an offensive tackle.
Football tickles the 45-yard line in Highland Park territory. The snap to give, straight drive play, out to the 50-yard line before he is gang tackled. Carries running back and Lynn Waters out of the fullback spot. Don Hurry, there was the initial shot for Plano, late help from Chad Farrell. First down was realized, spot the football right on the 50-yard stripe.
They're halfway between their own end zone and pay dirt as the offensive line for the Highland Park Scots is really blowing the defensive line for the Wildcats off the ball right now.
Out over the football, bending in, looking left, looking right, is Stollenworth, the quarterback. Mays, Nall in the backfield, busted play. Stollenworth gets the hand away to Mays, not much doing over right guard. Stacking things up, Clements wide left. Split Mike McCullough wide to the right side. Mays, Nall, tandem in the backfield. Stollenworth drops to throw. The left-hander rolls left, has the corner. Now Plant will throw, has his man Clements inside the 30-yard line of Wildcat territory. Dropped immediately on the play by Kyle Moody, the corner. Clements, Stollenworth hook up for their second big gain of the night.
A real big gain is
spot the football on the left hash mark. 20 yards on the pickup from Stollenworth to Clements. Scott looks sidelines left, open field to the right side, running inside over right guard, piling down to the 25-yard line, fullback Lynn Waters. Two-man tackle, Don Hurry and Terry Price for the Wildcats, but not before Waters was able to pick up 3, maybe 4 yards. Spotted at the 26-yard line.
Let's set that Highland Park offense, Brad, on the line. We have center Doug Barnes, guards Trey Smith and Ernie Williamson at the tackles, Matt McCarron and David Turner.
Check it, it's Reggie Howard who limps across to the far sideline with Stollenworth barking the cadence. Second and 8 from the 26-yard line, Wildcat territory. Nall picks his way over left guard inside the 20, down to the 19-yard line. They'll touch him down at the 20 for a 6-yard pickup.
There was a flag on the play, Brad. One of the Wildcats defensive linemen did jump offside. Looks like they will take the 3 5-yards. They'll bring up a second down and 2 yards to go for the Highland Park Scots on the first flag of the night.
Spot the football, just a shade inside the left hash mark. Stollenworth takes first man through wheel. Keep trying to run wide left side, not much doing. Nice springing out of the play by Plano's defense. Nice pursuit and gang tackling. Highland Park, third down, a yard to go. They snap it from the Wildcat 19-yard line. Stollenworth, hand first man through. Nall gets the first down plus a pair. Down to the 17, and maybe the 16-yard line. They'll touch him down at the 17. First and 10, Highland Park. There's the Scots. They look at sidelines left, open field to the right side. Tandem in the backfield, flanker wide right, rolling to the right side. Stollenworth is upended by Chad Farrell in the backfield. Loss of 6, maybe 7 yards on the play. They'll touch Stollenworth down at the 22-yard. Wideouts right and left for Highland Park, dropping to throw. Stollenworth has time, now throws over the middle, has his man at the 6-yard line. Knocked down by Kyle Moody, the receiver, Wayne Clement, the flanker.
A tremendous catch by Wayne Clements of Stollenworth, jumping all over the place out here. He was had a lot of pressure. The Wildcats blitzed. He threw a bullet. Clements made a tremendous catch, and Kyle Moody dropped him as soon as he caught the ball.
Highland Park passing Plano Dizzy on their initial possession. The Scots average only 69 yards passing. Stollenworth bends in. The snap, the hand, Nall over left tackle. Bullies his way inside the 4 to the 3-yard line. Linebacker Mark Bowman from the strong side of Plano's defensive scheme of things makes the tackle, but not before a solid 3-yard pickup by running back James Nall.
James Nall, a powerful runner. He's their number 2 rusher of the season. Tremendous blocking for Matt McCarron and Ernie Williamson as the third.
Long count the line by Stollenworth. Gives off. Nall over left tackle, not much doing. Sacked up for a short game. Maybe picked up a half a yard. Maybe inched his way down to the 2-yard line. Will be third down, goal to go.
The Wildcat defense stiffened there as they did not allow that big, strong left side of the offensive line.
Stollenworth gives running right. Nall stops short. Stops at the 1-yard line. Gang tackling inside by the Wildcats. Getting up off of the stack, I see Terry Price along with Johnny Harvey and Thomas Stroh.
Brad,
ball just
ball.
Short, inches short of the goal line.
That ball, there's not much green between the ball. The tip.
James Nall, Lynn Waters in the backfield behind quarterback Stollenworth, who will give to Waters, who dives in over right guard to the Scott touchdown. very, very smart drive on the initial possession by Highland Park. They go up by a 6-0 count, 4:09 left to play. First to Wayne Clements to try to tack on the PAT. The snap's back, the ball's on the tee, it's on the way, and it's on the board. New score, 4:09 left to play initial period at Texas Stadium. Highland Park 7, play no nothing.
Back at Texas Stadium as a stunned Plano Wildcat team has taken the field to receive the kickoff off the toe of Wayne Clements as the Highland Park Scots have taken the ball right down the throats of the Wildcats and scored here at the opening possession of tonight's ball game.
Wildcats deploy a tandem in Kyle Moody on the far side, along with Chad Farrell. Here's the approach from Clements. The kick is a wobbly kick fielded by Moody at the 7-yard line. Beers right across the 15-20. Breaks the tackle at the 25, spins out across the 30 to the 33-yard line. Kyle Moody. Here's Tony Cook and the offensive crew. Reverse spin, inside hand, Austin over right guard, not much doing. Pickup of a yard, maybe a yard and a half for Scott Austin, the fullback, 181-pound senior. George C., the middle linebacker, teams up with defensive tackle Tom Nash on the tackle for the Scots. George C., returning starter, returning all-district performer from the middle linebacker spot. He's synonymous with the defense of Highland Park.
He's
second
sure.
Down, 8 yards to go. Wing right, now motion from a right to left from the wing back, Moody. Rolling left, quarterback Cook, stopped for no gain. Wrapping him up, linebacker Tripp Wood, along with defensive end Brian Owen. To set the Highland Park defense inside on the 4-3 look, the defensive tackles Tom Nash and Fred Behan, the ends of Mike Smith along with Brian Owen, a fine linebacking core headed by middle linebacker George C. Flank received the first, they work from their own 36. Rolling right, quarterback Cook, Will Keith, turns the corner, has the 37, has the 39-yard line before he is really drilled on the far sideline. Leading the charge, Tripp Wood, 160-pound senior, the outside linebacker. He posts on. Nice snap from center. No rush on. English gets a nose-up wobbly spiral. Touches down at the 30. Takes a big Plano bounce. Fielded by Smith at the 10. Driven down at the 7-yard line. Thomas Stroh, along with Mark Bowman. Two-man tackle on the punt returner, Steve Davis, as the ball really took the kangaroo hop off on the artificial surface in Plano's favor. Sidelines left, open field to the right side, motion from right to left by flanker McCullough. Dive, first man through, getting the football, James Knoll, stood up and driven down by defensive end Drew Caudell. Short pickup on the play, let's check the spot. They snapped it from just outside their own 8-yard line. Knoll carried it to the 10. Second down, 8 yards to go for Highland Park. They lead this one 7-0. Clock rolls. Second and 8 play on the way. Stallingworth rolling right. Turns it up. Has a crease. It closes in a hurry. Tripped up on the play by Don Hurry, the defensive end. Late help from Thomas Stroh, the safety. Stallingworth drops the throw, gives it away to Knoll. On the draw, has an alley across the 15 to the 19-yard line. Going to be close to the first down yardage. Going to be close to the first down. Dropped by Chad Farrell along with Scott English. The two from the 19-yard line in Scott territory. Here's Highland Park Stallingworth rolling left, drawing some attention, spinning out of a tackle at the 24, driving it out to the 26-yard line. Don Hurry making the stop.
That's the end of the quarter, Brad, but the Wildcats are going to have to stiffen up. A tremendous block that time by Lynn Waters, the fullback.
We're through one quarter of play at Texas Stadium. Our score, Highland Park 7, the Plano Wildcats nothing. The reverse spin out from center by Stallingworth, hands it away to running back James Knoll, is wrapped up and dropped by defensive tackle Tom Campbell. 215-pound senior, pickup of a yard maybe for running back Knoll on a counterplay going to the right side. Quarterback Stallingworth, the 195-pound package of poise, operates at the quarterback spot for Highland Park. Give it to Knoll over left tackle. Nothing doing. Stop short of the first down. Oh, leading the charge for Plano was the left-footed Wayne Clements hangs a jewel in the air. Fielded at the 26 by Moody. Beers left across the 30 is driven down at the 32-yard line. Plano will scrimmage from that juncture on the short side of a 7-0 score. 10:32 left to play, second period.
Bill Clements and Mike Schmidt, and on the tackle for the Scots as the Wildcats will be starting from their own 32-yard line. Their second possession of the night, the first possession, Brad, with three plays, very little offense. That Scott defense is as tough as
mine. Cook hands it away. McNeely finds a little bit of crease over left guard out to the 39-yard line. Three-yard pickup by Wally McNeely. Plano's leading rusher comes into this one with 1,078 yards on 151 carries. He was filled by Brian Owen, the right defensive end out of the Highland Park DB. Running to the right side is McNeely picks his way for first down yardage up to the 45-yard line. Wally McNeely of Plano on the carry. Right, fine blocking from tackle Richard Duvall, an offensive guard. Here's Cook, hands it away. Austin on the delay, running left for places. Now drives it out to the 50-yard line. Nice looking 5-yard pickup by Scott Austin on the draw play. Knocked down by outside linebacker Trip Wood, 160-pound senior. Fine blocking up front by Plano's offensive line, which reads Eric Woodcheck, Peter Marchese, Jeff Gurney over the football. On the quick side of the offensive line, Johnny Harvey at guard, Richard Duvall at the tackle. Running with the football inside, down to the 45. May have picked up the first down. Scott Austin, the senior, 181-pounder. Austin thus far on the night, 4 carries, 17 yards. Set Rose Sandich in the wing, reverse spin, handed away. McNeely nothing doing between the guards. Oh, really? Standing up, Wally McNeely inside with middle linebacker George C. That's how it's drawn up on the blackboard. Second down, 7 yards to go before the snap of the football. Flags fly. Looks like it might be a false start of procedure penalty against the Wildcats.
Looks like one of the offensive tackles for the Plano Wildcats jumped the gun a little bit. This is what the Wildcats did not need. They are going to have a penalty. It'll bring up a second down and 12 yards to go for the Wildcats.
You know, Plano really hurt themselves last week in a bi-district ball game with the flags. From the Highland Park 47, rolling to the left side. Quarterback Cook has some pressure. He's flushed out. Finally throws on the far sideline and has his man, Dwayne Shepherd, at the 32-yard line in Highland Park territory. Dwayne Shepherd on the ridge. Twirling out from center is Cook, handing it away to Wally McNeely, trying to crack it over right guard. Stopped in his tracks by Brian Owen. Maybe picked up a yard and a half. Wally McNeely had to struggle for all of it. Wildcat snapped the football. Rolling left is Cook. Jukes out of a tackle at the 30-yard line. Drives it inside to the 27. Tripwood, the linebacker, was faked for a moment, was able to recover, and drags down Tony Cook. It was the young junior, the quarterback for Plano, all alone outside with two Highland Park defenders, and Cook, only with his athletic ability, was able to drive it inside the 30 to the 27-yard line. Third down, 6 yards to go for the Wildcats. 5:50 left to play until intermission. Highland Park on top of it by a 7-0 count. Here's Plano. Third and six. The sidelines left. Open field to the right side. He pitches it to Moody. Rolling, running wide to the right side. Gets the block from Austin. Is tripped up at the 25. Drives it down to the 23-yard line. Depending on the spot, Kyle Moody may have the first down. Really a very, very fine job fighting through the block by a free safety, James Esquivel. Twin tight ends for Plano. McNeely and Austin behind quarterback Cook. Here's Cook rolling to the left side. Has a man to beat at the 30. Turns on the afterburners. Drives it down. Will not get the first down stick on the far sideline. Pulls up a yard short. Driven out of bounds inside the 30 at the 29-yard line was a junior quarterback, Tony Cook, leading the defensive charge. Defensive right end, Brian Owen, 200-pound senior. Really nice pursuit. Fine job of stringing out the play by Highland Park. They take possession on downs at their own 29-yard line. He gives it off to the first man through. Still in his backfield, Sullenwerk has the football, and he is nailed. Linebacker Scott Austin in his face after the back flag fly. Giving the football off to fullback Waters over left guard across the 30, driven down at the 32-yard line. Highland Park on top of it, 7-0. From their own 31-yard line, Stallenwerk drops to throw. The port sider fires on the flat, has his man McCullough at the 40-yard line. Highland Park territory. Boy, Mike McCullough had to really extend out and make a fine diving catch. Plenty for the first down, first and 10, spotted at the 40-yard line. Waters along with Nall in the backfield. The give is the first man through, James Nall, over right guard. Powers his way to the 42, maybe the 43-yard line, before he is knocked down by Terry Price, Jr., 225-pound defensive tackle for Plano. A the left-hander, wants to throw over the middle for Clements in the air. Incomplete pass over the outstretched arms of intended receiver Wayne Clements at the Plano 29-yard line. Bring it back to the line of scrimmage. Nice cover on the play by Plano's Castronova and Kyle Moody, the safety and defensive corner, respectively.
That was a tremendous throw. Stallenwerk has quite an arm, Brad.
Motion from right to left from McCullough in front of the backs. Stallenwerk hands inside, finding a big hole. His fullback Waters across the 45, surges out to the 48, maybe the 49-yard line. Be short of the first down by a yard, maybe two. Kaminsky on the near side, Moody on the far side to bring back the Clements punt. It's a line drive kick. Fair catch called for by Kyle Moody at the 20. Moody, true to his word, Plano will scrimmage. A Cook will keep off a right tackle. Really has to struggle and drive it out for a two-yard pickup to the 22-yard line. Nice block by Gurney, but really too many white shirts. Steve Davis, the corner, was there. Cook twists out from center, hands it away. Over right tackle to McNeely. Terry spots out across the 25 to the 27-yard line. Inside hand on the draw play. Scott Austin, Highland Park will buy none of it. George C., along with defensive tackle Tom Nash. The timeout called on the field by Highland Park with 50 seconds left until halftime. Highland lost a yard and a half on the play for Plano. The Wildcats will be forced to punt. Plano forced to punt inside a minute left to play. Second period. Doug Fallis over the football. He'll snap it to Scott English. Nice number high pass from center. English will get the toe into it. Lifts a wobbly kick fielded by Brandon Williams. A fair catch with executed inside the 45 at the 44-yard line. Highland Park territory. Stallenwerk hands it away. Whip an alley across the 50-yard line into positive territory. Running back James Nall. Finally knocked down on a late tackle by Scott English, the outside linebacker. Stallenwerk drops to throw. Pump fake now. Throws long up the far sideline. Overthrows intended receiver Mike McCullough at the 15-yard line in Plano territory. But they're covering very, very nicely was corner Dwayne Shepherd. Stallenwerk, option near side, will pitch. Has Nall, tight ropes the near sideline inside the 45 to the 43-yard line. Highland Park breaks the huddle, comes out over the football, and there's an official timeout call. Take a look at it, our referee, Eugene Smith. Looking across, we'll have a little bit of chatter with the chain gang across the way. Doug Barnes, the big center, comes out over the football, leads the Scots out of the huddle. Over the football is Barnes bending in. Quarterback John Stallenwerk, reverse spin, running to the left side, pitching very late to James Nall, knocked out of bounds below us. Mike drops to throw. The port sider looks long, throws up the far sideline, intercepted by Rosandich at the 18-yard line. Dropping the throw, the junior quarterback, Cook, puts it up in the air for Shepherd inside the 20. It's picked off. Steve Davis, the corner, very, very nicely on the cover, makes the interception. The pass was intended on the fly route for Dwayne Shepherd, so we exchange possessions. Now only 2 seconds left in the first half. Stallenwerk will simply take the snap from center, go down on the right knee as time expires. We're through two quarters, one half of football from Texas Stadium in Irving. Our score finds the Highland Park Scots on top of the Plano Wildcats by a 7-0 score. Our halftime programming when Plano Wildcat football continues after these messages.
They've picked up 131 yards. Brad, fumbles, we haven't had a fumble tonight yet. Interceptions, we've gone over that. The Wildcats have picked one off, and so have the Scots. Penalties, they've hurt the Wildcats. They've had three penalties, only all three of the five-yard variety, an illegal procedure and a face mask were the two big ones, as the Wildcats were slowed down on a drive with the illegal procedure. And the first, the face mask was a big play. The Wildcats had a tremendous defensive play, but got called for a face mask. Punting the ball, the Wildcats punted twice for 37 yards, Highland Park twice for 38 yards, so no big discrepancy there. Penetration, the first tiebreaker, the Scots have won, the Wildcats have zero. Time of possession, another very big statistic here. Highland Park had the ball for 14 minutes and 45 seconds, the Wildcats for 9 minutes and 15 seconds. Brad, other than that first drive from the Highland Park offense, the Wildcats and the Scots have played pretty evenly.
They have really stood toe-to-toe and slugged it out between the 20s, as you mentioned, other than that first drive. Kev, scoring summary of that first drive. Give us the history book on the possession.
Okay, that was the initial drive of the ball game as the Scots took the ball 15 plays, won 83 yards, took 7 minutes and 51 seconds off the clock, and we had Lynn Waters go in from 1 yard out, or check that, James Noel went in from 1 yard out. Lynn Waters from 1 yard out, and the Scots broke the ice, and the Wildcats were scored on in the first quarter.
Line drive, nose up, spiral, touches down at the 12, fielded on a big hop by Kyle Moody at the 10, across the 15, filled at the 20-yard line. Split Jake Kaminsky wide left. Shepherd wide to the right side. Tandem in the backfield behind Cook before the football is snapped. Flags fly. Plano guilty of a little bit of wiggling before the snap of the football. Procedure penalty will cost the Cats 5.
This is something the offensive coach hates to see, especially starting the second half, the Wildcats being pushed back 5 yards for illegal procedure.
Center Gurney with the snap, Cook off a left tackle. Oh, is he level? Across the 15, driving to the 16-yard line, Tony Cook, Fred Behan, 205-pound senior defensive tackle, nearly knocked the numbers off of the maroon jersey of Tony Cook.
Fred Behan shot out of a cannon as Tony Cook looked like he had a lane to go up.
Pitch sweep running wide to the right side is Kyle Moody. Gets a block, struggles down the near sideline across the 20 to the 23-yard line. Kyle Moody, the ball carrier, ushered out of bounds by outside linebacker Trip Wood. Here's Cook pitching to Moody. Plants on the halfback option, throwing for Rosendi. Steve broken up at the last minute, 40-yard line in Highland Park. Top territory by corner Steve Davis. Really did a number on the cover.
Steve Davis, tremendous play on the cover. He volleyball passed that ball out of the hands of Kyle Moody for the Wildcats. Rosandage for the Wildcats.
He was got English to do the kicking waist-high snap. Line drive kick. Fair catch called for, executed just inside Highland Park territory by James Esker.
Third down and inches for the Scots as they decided not to bring the chains all the way across the field.
Stalling work bends in. Give it to the running back. Waters has a big haul across the 40. Finally dragged down after substantial gain by Thomas Stroh. First down was recorded. Fine running by James Knoll, the halfback, 180-pound senior for Highland Park. Real Plano with the 4-3 look. Off a left tackle, Knoll finds another alley inside the 35, driving it down to the Wildcat 33-yard line before he is dropped by Drew Caudell and Thomas Stroh. Highland Park moving the football on Plano third period. Works from the 26-yard line, pitch sweep wide right. Knoll with the football, gang tackled. Inside the 35 at the 33-yard line, maybe lost a yard on the play. Castronova, Dawn, a hurry, Tom Campbell, all in on the play for Plano. Split backs in the backfield. Here's Stolen work, handing away on the draw play. Knoll has a big crease. Inside the 30, dropped at the 25, maybe the 24-yard line in Wildcat territory by safety Thomas Stroh, along with strong side linebacker Mark Bowman. Oh, the draw play, the delay, call it what you may, it's working for big yardage for Highland Park.
It sure was. They could have driven a truck through that hole again. They did it in the first quarter, and they've done it here in the third quarter as the Highland Park Scots are forced to call a timeout here to get things straightened up on the field.
Highland Park on a very impressive drive, third period. 8:31 left to play in the frame. Stallenwerk gives it off. Knoll finds a crease over right tackle. Finally, pursuit catches up to him. Gang tackled at the 22, maybe the 21-yard line. Pick up a 2, maybe 3. Looks like here's Stallenwerk and his offensive crew for Highland Park on the draw that gives to Knoll. Ankle-high tackle. David Overdick, the defensive tackle, able to snuff out the draw play. motion from the flanker McCullough from right to left. And here's Stallingworth rolling to the left side. Has pressure, reverses his field way back at the 35-yard line. Stallingworth to the 30. Oh, upended at the 28-yard line. Fumbles the football. Stallingworth fumbles the football. There's a big pileup at the 25 in Plano territory. They're going to say he was down. Highland Park will try to kick the field goal from the 34, a 44-yard attempt from left-footed sidewinder Clemson. The pass from center's back, the spot down, the kick is high enough, long enough, and it could not. Wayne Clement, perfect from 44 yards out. 6:31 left to play, third period, new score on the board. Highland Park 10, 6.5 minutes left to play, third period. The kickoff of the toe of Clements bounds inside the 10, kicks out of bounds at the 1 yard line. Flags fly. Highland Park will kick it again, this time from the 35-yard line. The kick is a high kick, fielded by Moody at the 10. Veers left to the 20, 25, knocked out of bounds at the 27-yard line. Leading the charge, Bill Clements. Linebacker by trade, 5'11", 170-pound senior. Plano down by a 10-0 count, will scrimmage from their own 27-yard line. Cook fakes first man through, will roll to the right side, and my goodness, switch hammered down at the 28-yard line. Brady Giddens, 210-pound outside linebacker, led the charge. Also there, Tom Nash, the defensive tackle, along with quick out pass from Cook to Kaminsky. Nets some short yardage across the 30 to the 34-yard line. Kaminsky bumped out of bounds immediately below us by cornerback Matt Johnson. Second down, 4 yards to go. Handed away, running back McNeely over right tackle, drives it to the 38, maybe the 39-yard line. I believe he did record the first down. Initial first down recorded by Plano in half number two. No, bends in, wants to throw. Quick drop, quick throw. Has Shepard, far side, breaks the tackle. Plano 45 in the positive territory. Knocked out of bounds at the Scott 46-yard line by Tripp Wood, the outside backer. Plano starting to loosen things up, throw the football. Flags fly, Cook rolls left, throws over the top of intended receiver. And the officiating crew near midfield having a conference. Now a referee breaks it out. Illegal procedure. Wildcats send to Shepard wide left. Bowman wide to the right side. Straight drop. Quarterback Cook, the port sider, throws over the middle, intended for Wally McNeely out of the backfield. McNeely can't hang on. Bring it down to the 46-yard line. Third down, 10 yards to go. Highland Park territory. Plano in possession. Cook back to throw. Has pressure. Flushed out of the pocket. Jitterbugs at the 45-yard line. Breaks the tackle at the 40. Driven down at the 39-yard line. Short by 2, maybe 3 yards of what's needed to achieve the first at the 36-yard line, Highland Park territory. Here's quarterback Cook. Jitterbugs out of a tackle. He stops short after he cuts it up off a left tackle. Stops short at the 37-yard line. Cook dropped at the 37, stopped a yard and a half, maybe 2 yards short. Highland Park takes over on downs. Fred Vihan, the defensive tackle, along with help from linebackers Tripp Wood and George C. Oh, my, what a defensive clinic given thus far by Highland Park.
Highland
spotted at the 38. Let's go the other way from a right to left. Highland Park, first and 10 play on the way. Inside hand, Nora with the football. Bobbled the thing after he took an initial shot, was able to retain possession. Not much. Here's the John Stallingworth. Drops to throw, has pressure, finds his man, Nall, out of the backfield. Highland Park 40, James Nall to the 45, Nall to midfield. English on the tackle, out of the linebacking spot for Plano, but not before the completion from quarterback Stallingworth to running back James Nall nips it out to midfield. Highland Park from midfield, first and 10. Right side, Nall, big hole, 45, far sideline, James Nall is on his way. At the 20, he will score. 15-10 by touchdown, Highland Park. James Nall broke it and broke it big. Off a right tackle, 50 yards on the touchdown scamper. Highland Park stretches the lead now to 16-0.
The Wildcat faithful are shocked over there. It's a tremendous run by James.
Nice pass from center. The ball's on the tee, on the way, and bingo, on the board for Highland Park. 2:38 left to play, period number three, new score. Wayne Clements has it teed up. The left-footed sidewinder approaches and kicks a wobbly kick fielded by Moody at the 5, veers to the right side, 10, 15, 20. Kyle Moody still on his feet across the 30-yard line, drops at the 32, firing down the field, Trip Waters. Wide outs right and left, quarterback Cook rolls to the left side, plants and throws, intended for Kaminsky, in and out of the diving. Jeff Gurney leads the cast out over the football. He'll snap it to Tony Cook. Give it away to Wally McNeely, running wide to the left side, gets the block, has the corner. 35, tripped up at the 37-yard line. Inside counter trap, give it away. McNeely driving across the 40, lowers the head and surges out to the 42-yard line behind a pretty good-looking block by offensive guard Barton Rostrum. Checking the spot, let's see. Did he record the first down? It looks like they are about 6 inches short. It'll bring up a fourth down and 6 inches to go. To snap the hand is to McNeely, has the first down plus a yard and a half. Out to the right side, Cook rolls to the left. Now plants, throws for Shepherd, far sideline. Incomplete, too tall for the intended receiver, wide right. Moody in motion behind the backs, pitch it to Kyle Moody, running wide to the right side, turns it upfield and finds some white-shirted Scott. On the snap, rolls to the left side, throws long across the way on the far sideline, intended for Kaminsky, broken up nicely on the far sideline by free safety James Esquivel. Oh my, Kaminsky looked like he might have had a step or two on Esquivel, but he came out of nowhere to bat the thing away at the last moment. Fourth down, waist-high snap. English gets the kick away, angling towards the middle of the field. Touches down at the 25-yard line. Takes a big Plano bounce inside the 20, inside the 15. Finally, touchdown at the Highland Park 10-yard line. First and 10 for the Scottsdale scrimmage from their own 10 with 2 seconds left to play third period. Down, quick count, inside hand, picking his way over left guard, bouncing inside fullback Lynn Waters to the 12, to the 13-yard line as time expires. We're through three at Texas Stadium in Irving. Our score, Highland Park 17, Plano nothing. Quarter action, Highland Park, second and six. They work from their own 14-yard line. Stollenwerk fakes first man through, pitches wide to the left side, running with the football as Nall fumbles it out of bounds. Might have heard the roar. Third and 10 play on the way. Quarterback Stollenwerk gives it away on the draw. Nall picks his way across the 10 to the 13, maybe the 14-yard line. Way short of the nice snap from center. Wobbly kick touches down in Highland Park territory at the 42. Kicks out of bounds at the 46-yard line. Plano first and 10, 11:22 left to play. Plano down 17 and nothing. Plano, Cook hands it away. Now, no, rolls with it on his hip. Wide left, plants to throw the football, and it's batted down. Ball getting a big mid up there. Dropping the throw, Cook straight back. The left-hander fires near flat. Can't find his receiver, Wally McNeely, at the 45-yard line in Wildcat territory. Bring it back to the line of scrimmage. The Cook, inside hand, on the draw. Austin has a big hole inside the 40, inside the 35. Trips up at the 31-yard line. First and 10 play on the way from the Highland Park 32-yard line. Cook drops the throw, has Kaminsky. Kaminsky drops the football at the 22-yard line. Fine defense by Steve Davis. Cook drops the throw, has pressure, is flushed out of the pocket, lowers his head and drives it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. Here's Cook dropping the throw. The left-hander, a pump fake, goes for all of it. For Dwayne Shepherd inside the 5, dropping the throw, Tony Cook dances in his backfield, now fires, has his man inside the 20. Nice reception made by a quick drop by Cook, goes in the far flat, as Shepherd breaks the tackle at the 15, able to squirt down to the 13, maybe the 12-yard line. And inside hand over the right guard on a trap play. They'll set it down at the 5-yard line. First and goal, Plano. Wide outs right and left. Here's Cook, reverse spin inside hand. Austin over the 5 and is really stood up and driven back at the 4-yard line. Pitch it wide, sweeping left. Kyle Moody breaks the tackle at the 5. Inside hand, McNeely breaks the tackle at the 2, drives it into the end zone for the Wildcat touchdown. Wally McNeely, 4-yard touchdown scamper, 8.5 minutes left to play. Plano on the board. Nice pass from center, the spot down. The English kick is on the way and he's good. 8:31, left to play, new score, Highland Park 17, Plano 7. Well, Highland Park has eight people up near the midfield stripe from the 40-yard line. McNeely kicks it away, kicks it high, kicks it long, touches down 6 yards in the end zone, kicks through. Highland Park will scrimmage from their own 20-yard line, leading Plano 17-7, 8 minutes, 31 seconds left to play, fourth period. First and 10 for the Scots. They work from their own 20-yard line. Inside hand, first man through, Nall over right guard for 2, maybe 3 yards. Gang tackling inside by Plano. Don Hurry, along with Johnny Harvey, lead the charge. Set it down at the 23. Second down, 7 yards to go for Highland Park. Now motion out of McCullough from right to left. Stalling work inside hand. Big hole. Nall with the football. Across the 25, driving it out to the 30-yard line. James Knoll records the first down before he's tackled by Rich Castanova. Here's Stalin work inside hand. Nothing doing over right tackle. Football was tackled by Chad Farrell. Carrying the thing was a running back, James Knoll. Carl Thompson also in on the stop for Plano defensively. The pickup to the 32. Call it second down, a long 8 yards to go. Motion, Adam McCullough from right to left. Reverse spin, inside hand. Knoll picks his way between the guards across the 35. Drives it out to the 37-yard line. Knocked down by Thomas Stroh. Tremendous effort by James Knoll, the running back for Highland Park. A senior, 180-pounder, stands 5'10". Now with, let's check the numbers on the night. 131 yards, 28 carries. Boy, Knoll with the hand. Knoll, check it. It's Waters over right guard across the 40. Driven down just across the 40. Well, depend on the spot. First down recorded by Annette Whisker. Now motion from right to left out of McCullough. Sidelines right, open field to the left side. Stalling work will roll left, will cut it up off a left tackle across the 41 to the 42-yard line. Knocked down by linebacker Scott English, along with help from defensive tackle Tom Campbell. Second down long. Inside hand, Knoll, nothing doing. Cracks it out, breaks an arm tackle at the 43, drives to the 45-yard line. 2, maybe 3 yards on the pickup. Plano with a 4-3 defensive alignment. Off a right tackle, the give is to Knoll, not much doing. To the 47-yard line. Nice pass from center. Flags fly at the line of scrimmage. Whistles blow. A fine kick off of the toe of Clements, but let's bring it back. And Clements gets the kick away. A high kick, touches down at the Plano 18, takes a Wildcat bounce across the 20-yard line. Down at that juncture, Plano will scrimmage first and 10 from just across their own 20-yard line. Here's Cook, quick drop throws, has Shepard near sideline, pick up a 3, maybe 4 yards. Shepard bumped out of bounds at the 24-yard line, dropped quarterback Cook to throw. Plants now fires for Shepard at the 37, tips away, flags fly after the fact. May have a defensive pass interference call against Matt Johnson. Covering nicely on Dwayne Shepard. Tony Cook drops the throw. The left-hander pumps on the sideline. That has Kaminsky at midfield. Driven out of bounds across the way by Steve Davis. Over drives it to the 47-yard line in Scott territory. Tandem in the backfield, dropping the throw. Quarterback Cook wants a bundle over the middle, intended for Shepard. Overthrows the receiver at the 15-yard line. And the near flat has the corner at the 45, 40, 35, 30, down at the 26-yard line. Wally McNeely of Plano finally dragged it down by George C. and James Escavel. Our territory, Cook fires quickly. As Bowman. Bowman drops the football. Knocked away by cornerback Steve Davis in the far flat. The clock stops. Second and 10, 2:50 left to play at Texas Stadium. As quarterback Cook, pump fake on the quarterback draw. Will scamper inside the 25, trips up. Drives down to the 23-yard line. It was C, the linebacker, a very, very intelligent defensive football player for Highland Park, but none of the quarterback draw. A timeout spent by Plano. 2:42 left to play at Texas Stadium. Our score continues. Highland Park 17, Plano 7. Here's a Plano offensively. Over the football, center Jeff Gurney, under quarterback Tony Cook. wideouts right and left, fakes the delay. Cook will keep on the draw play, it trips up and drives it inside the 25. Maybe was able to scramble back to the line of scrimmage to stop 23-yard line. Fred Behan, defensive tackle, 205-pound senior. Takes the draw play, backfield now plants, throws up the near sideline. In and out of the hands of intended receiver Wally McNeely out of the backfield at the Highland Park 10. Scots will take possession from their own 24-yard line. 2:23 left to play. Just about should close out Plano. Plano has spent all three second-half timeouts. Stallenwerk, the poised engineer of this offensive ball club for Highland Park, hands it away. Lynn Waters. No, it's Stallenwerk on the fake to Waters. We'll keep it running wide to the right side. Turns the quarter, has the 30, has the Plano 31. Bumped out of bounds by Tom Campbell and Don Hurry. Just inside the 32-yard line in Scott territory. And send Clements in motion from right to left. Hand it away to Nall over left guard. Nothing doing. Flags fly.
No, it's going to be offside against the Plano Wildcat defense, which will give the Wildcats give the Scots a first down from their own 42-yard line.
Hand it away. Nall left side. Nothing doing. Gang tackle led by Drew Caudill. Also pinching in. Defensive tackle Overdick, along with help from his compadre at the defensive tackle spot. Second down, 11 yards to go. Highland Park from the 32, flags fly. Delay of the game will cost the Scotties five. Inside hand, first man through. Water again, flags fly, and again, it's a delay of the game penalty against Highland Park.
I don't believe Coach Beavers wants to have too many of these delay of games. It's just going to back the Scots up.
17 from their own 30-yard line. Stallenwerk inside hand, first man through, powering over left guard. Make it right guard is James Nall. No, correction, football carrier was fullback Lynn Waters, brought down by Thomas Stroh, the senior, 160-pound safety for Plano.
Looks like the officials may let it run out.
Last snap of the football, handed to Waters, has a crease out to the 35, driven down at the 39-yard line by Jake Kaminsky as time expires. Well, it was a dandy from Texas Stadium. It'll go into the history books as a 17-7 Highland Park Scott win over the Plano Wildcats. For our broadcast crew of statistician Mick Cody, remote engineer Daryl Dawes, for station coordinator Al Brassel, along with Kevin Maloney, this is Brad Denton reminding you our final score from Texas Stadium, the Highland Park Scots 17, the Plano Wildcats 7. 4
came in Garrett quarterback John Stallenwerk.